Okay, so this is problem number 10 from chapter 4. A pretty challenging problem, because there's two big tricks in it. So let me set up the two tricks and a little bit more, and give you a big push on your way. So here's a setup of the problem, okay? And you've got a mass that's hanging here. I've got two masses to represent that one, okay? You've got a mass up there that's attached by this pulley with a string attached to the wall. See how this is the same setup in the problem? I'm gonna let it go and you watch it and see what it does. As I drop this, okay, pulley fell over. Notice this went down and that went over. Okay? Now, without the masses, I'm going to do this again and make a few marks on here so you can see what's happening. A little bit slower here. Okay, so I'm going to scoot this back again to the starting point. I'm going to put a little mark up here. This mass here, I'll draw it from the front end, starts there, that mark. Okay? It starts right there. And my hand starts right here at the 20 centimeter mark. Okay? Now I'm going to pull this over till that mass hit the pulley, okay, which is right there. And my hand went down here just past the 30 centimeter mark, maybe to here. Okay? So from here to here, that's how far the mass fell, but from here to there, that's how far that mass went over. And if we were to measure this, and I'll grab a ruler here, it's kind of a ruler anyway, it's got some little marks on it. This one went this far, from here to there. Now compare that here. Look at that. It's twice the distance. Do y'all see that? This distance is half that distance. Okay? So here's my point. This one is mass 2, so the distance that this traveled and the distance that this traveled are not the same because of the way those pulleys are set up. And you can kind of look at those pulleys and watch it a couple of times, run the rewind and watch that a couple of times, and you'll notice that this thing moves twice as far, twice as fast as this one. So let me say that again. D2 is twice D1, the distance mass 2 travels is twice the distance that mass 1 travels. And if the distance is twice as far, the speed is twice as far, and also the acceleration is twice as fast. And that's the big key. That's the hardest part of this whole problem. So the reason I set all this up here is so that you can easily see that A2 is twice A1. This mass will accelerate twice as fast as that mass. And the only reason that is because of the way these pulleys are set up. As I move this one down, that pulley has to go at the same speed because it's attached by this rope. And this pulley is attached to the wall, so it's not going to move. So the only thing that can move is this end. And so it has to move twice as far just to keep up. That's the first big key, okay? The next thing you notice, okay, so before we even started the problem, I just labeled that up there for you. So I'm gonna erase these little markings here, erase this, okay? And leave that, because that's an important part. You need that for this problem. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna look at this and we're gonna label the forces on here, okay? Pull this back a little bit, okay? This mass, what are the forces? Well, you got mass pulling, weight, force of gravity pulling it down, tension pulling it up. So for this one, the sum of the forces, when we write that out, we're going to say the weight, the force of gravity, is pulling it down, so it gets a negative sign, and the tension is pulling it up, so it gets a positive sign. We're going to call this T1 because this tension, and they're two different ropes, right? This is a rope, and this is a rope. They're two different tensions. And this is going to equal to M times A. This is M1. Let me write this out one more step here. And flip this order so I have positive first, just because I like to do it that way. No good reason, really. Tension minus M1 times G equals M1 times A. There's one more catch. Notice this mass accelerates down. So this acceleration is negative, which makes this term negative. That's a very important little negative sign there. Okay, so we've got tension minus M1G equals negative M1A. How many unknowns do we have here? Tension 1, and acceleration 1. Two unknowns, one equation. You say, well, wait a second, there's another equation up there. Yes, you're right. So now we've got two unknowns. Let me circle them. This one and this one. Two unknowns and a second equation. And one of those unknowns is repeated again right there. But here's a third unknown. Oh, no. That means we need a third equation. Where are we going to get that? Well, let's do some of the forces on this mass. Okay? So for that mass, we're going to do sum of the forces equals MA, okay? And notice the only force pulling this thing is tension. Tension pulls it to the right. And I think this is a frictionless problem. Let me double check that. Yes, it's a frictionless table. So you've got tension pulling it to the right, no friction opposing motion, and that equals mass times acceleration. Which mass is this? This is M2 and acceleration 2. But this is tension 2. Not the same as that tension. And then you say, but wait a second, what about normal force and gravity? You're right. Those are there too. We've got normal force pulling it up, gravity pulling it down. We have both of those. But they're in the y direction. This only accelerates in the x direction, so we're not going to worry about those right now. Okay? So we're looking at this, and I'm saying, okay, how many unknowns do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 unknowns. 1, 2, 3 equations. Oh no, we need another equation. Where are we going to get it? Well, the only place we can. We look at this and we say, there is another object moving. Watch this thing go. When I pull this string, what else moves? Yeah, that spins, but that's massless. This mass moves. Watch that pulley. That pulley moves also. So we need to do some of the forces on the pulley as well. So I'm going to write that up here. Do sum of the forces equals MA for the pulley. And what are the forces? Well, look at this. On that side, we've got that rope right there. That rope is pulling it to the right. That's T1. And we have this rope pulling it to the left and this rope pulling it to the left. You see how there's two T2s pulling it that way? So we're going to do minus T2 minus T2 equals the mass of the pulley times acceleration. Now, what's the mass of that pulley? Well, this is a goofy question. I say goofy because it's not very realistic. In reality, everything has mass, but for the purposes of this problem, they say that pulley is very light. What does that mean? That means It's so lightweight, you don't have to worry about it. So as far as we're concerned, and the only reason we're doing it this way is because if the pulley has mass, the problem becomes much more complicated. And we're gonna deal with that in a handful of chapters. But for now, we're just gonna say the pulley has no mass. So in our mass times acceleration, the mass is zero. Which is to say, if this side is zero, then we have T1 minus 2T2 equals zero. Which is to say, T1 equals 2T2, because you can just add this to both sides and get it down there. Okay, four equations, four unknowns. One equation, two equation, three equations, four. Four equations, four unknowns. Algebra says you can solve it now. And that's the physics for this problem. Getting it set up is the hardest part. Now there's some algebra involved, yes, but the physics is what this class is about. So getting it to the point where you've got four equations and four unknowns, knowing how to get those equations, and notice this one you had to catch from understanding how pulleys work. And you say, well, I would have never got that. Don't worry, that's why I did the demonstration for you. That's a hard one to grasp. And to be fair, if you were here in the study session, you noticed that I did it wrong the first time too. Figuring pulleys out is a trick, and the best way to figure them out is to make it happen. So once you make it happen, you can understand better what's going on, okay? So this one is a trick, I agree, it's tricky. After that, everything else is just application of Newton's second law to the three moving objects, okay? So where do you go from here? Well, from here you do some algebra, and you do it, it's the same as solving two equations and two unknowns, it's just you gotta do it four times, so there's four equations and four unknowns. So I would take this one and plug it in there for T1, and I would take this one and plug it in there for A2, and then once I had that, combine that one with this one. So, this will have a T2. So then take this whole thing, which will have that in it, and plug it in to the T2 that'll be up there after you plug this in. Okay? So I kind of waved my hands a bit there, but it's just algebra. I'll let you handle the algebra. The physics stepped you through very carefully. But the algebra is just solve, use all four equations at different times. Plug this in there, plug this in, plug it into each one. Okay? So there you go. There's problem number 10, chapter 4. Hope this helps. Oh, by the way, I did all the algebra steps on the first study session video. And the algebra steps are correct. The only thing that's wrong on the first study session video is this one. I had a half there when I should have had a two, because I set up the pulleys in the wrong way. Okay, I hope this helps, and have a good day.